Hi, I'm Louise Pennington, Professional Development Leader for Numicon at Oxford University Press, and I'm going to walk you through a quick activity today focusing on perimeter from Teacher's Aid Handbook 4, Geometry, Measurement and Statistics. So I've just set up a couple of common shapes here. So I've got a square, a triangle, and we're going to talk about the perimeter being the inside measurement of this. So this is a 5 by 5 square, so 4 lots of 5. Answer is 20, and we can check by dropping this into the rod track. So 4 lots of 5 makes 20, so the perimeter of that shape is 20. Then focusing on the triangle, which is using the 8 rods. So we think it's 3 lots of 8. We can check by dropping those also into the rod track. We can see it's 24, so 3 8's 24. Lots of practice with common shapes, and we start to move on to some composite shapes here. So I'll just draw one quickly on the board here. So drawn a composite shape. We've got some values missing, so we need to work those out first. So we can see this side here is going to be 3 centimetres, because we have a 2 plus something makes the 5. So that's definitely 3. This one here, this whole length is 4. We've got 2 centimetres here. So this length here has also got to be 2 centimetres. So we can start to pick these up by saying, okay, we've got 2 centimetres. These are the 2 rods, 2 centimetres, 2 centimetres, a 3 centimetre down the side, a 4 centimetre and a 5. Also, we can think about brackets if you want to. So it's 3 lots of 2 there plus the others. And we can check our answer after we've estimated and tried to work that out. Drop them in the rod track just to double check. The answer is indeed 18. And then there's a really nice Explore More Copper Matter that goes with this, which is called Help the Baker. And this focuses on rectilinear shapes. And we're beginning to think about just needing a pencil here. So some common shapes and then some composite rectilinear shapes as well. Really nice to think about in terms of a homework activity.